Good morning. Welcome back to my Learn with Tom Lee. Espanol Esencial, the Spanish Essential, 西班牙文的基础。Today we are talking about Tiempo Presente, the present tense of the Spanish sentence, 西班牙文的现在式句子。From now on, I will record every video with the English version and the Cantonese version. And in this video, the Cantonese version will start at this time here.Debo, debemos, the type of verbs. In Spanish, just like English, we have regular verbs. These verbs are easy to get along with because they follow the regular conjugation rule for AR ending verb, ER ending, and IR ending verbs. And this AR, ER, and IR is the infinitive form of the verb.And every word is falls on these three categories, either IR ending, ER ending, or AR ending. The steam changing words. These words morph depending on how you use them in a sentence. You encounter three types of steam changing words classified according to their steam change from E to I, from E to IE.And from O to UE. And the spelling change verb. This means the irregular verb. Consonant spelling change occurs in some of the conjugated form of this verb. The change enables the verb to comply with pronunciation rules of the particular letters. The affected consonants are C, G, and Z. Sometimes,You have to change from C to Z and from G to J, depend on the verb. And the irregular verb, this word follows no rule and must be memorized. Some of the words are totally irregular, so they are conjugate and they are changed the whole word totally. So you have to remember.We continue with the debos, the bebos, the type of verbs. Reflexive verb. Whenever the subject does something to itself, you use a reflexive verb to express the fact that the action is performed or reflected back onto the subject of the sentence. In English, we seldom use the reflexive verbs, but in Spanish, we use a lot of reflexive verbs.So what is reflexive words? We will have some more example and you will understand what is reflexive in Spanish. El nombre personal de sujeto, the subject pronoun. A subject pronoun is a word used in place of a subject noun. For example, if your sentence is talking about John, sometimes you will replace this John with he.This pronoun identifies who or what is performed the action of the verbs. For example, he eats something or I do something. So the I or he is the subject pronoun. In Spanish, use the nice subject pronoun yo. This means I. Do is you, the informal you. If you're talking to your friends or someone you know well, so you use this informal form of you.Usted is the formal form of you when you're talking to your boss, your father, or your elder brothers. Someone you respect, you use the usted form. And él means he, ella, su, nosotros, we. And this we is the masculine we. This means all of us is masculine, all of us is male. And nosotros is all of us is female.Vosotros is you, the informal form of you. We only use this form of you, the plural form, right, in Spain. And some Spanish-speaking countries, just like the South America, they seldom use vosotros. They use the word ustedes. And vosotras is also talking about the plural form of you in the informal form. In the South Americas or other space speaking Spanish, they use ustedes.To replace the plural form of you. And ellos is they, the masculine form of they, and ella is they, the feminized form of day, as shown in the table 3.1. We go to table 3.1, el pronombre personal de sujeto, the subject pronoun. In the first person is yo, it means I. Plural form is nosotros or nosotras, mean we. Nosotros is the masculine plural form, and nosotras is the feminized plural form. The second person informal familiar of you, tú. Plural form is vosotros or vosotras. It's also masculine and feminized. This is single form of you. This is the plural form of you. And you know that in English, the plural form of you and the single form of you is also you only. Some of the English speakers, they will say it's you all. To emphasize, this is the plural form of you. The second person formal polite form of you is usted. And the contract form of usted is UD with the use capital. And ustedes is you, the plural form of you. That means you all. In the third person singular, el mean he, and ella mean she. Ellos is they, masculine days or mixed genders of they, and the ella is the feminized they. Now we are looking for some examples of el pronombre personal de sujeto, the subject pronoun. Yo me voy, I am leaving. Voy is go. The infinitive form is ir. So this verb is a irregular form. So when we join with the yo, we change the ir to voy. Yo me voy, this means I am leaving. Eduardo y yo salimos. Eduardo y yo mean we, because Eduardo and I salimos, we are leaving, or we are going out. Edwards and I are going out, and we use the form of the word is salimos. The actual infinitive form of this word is salir. Busca usted algo. Are you looking for something? We're looking for something. This is the word looking, and looking for or find something. And the actual word is buscar. B-U-S-C-A-R, buscar. So, busca usted algo. Are you looking for something? We change it to buscar. We change the AR form into A here. Ustedes necesitan ayuda. Do you need help? And this you is plural form. So ustedes, we change the necesidad into necesidad. If you want to find the conjugation of each word here in the present tense or in the past tense, you can go to the website SpanishStick.com and look for the word. For example, I'm looking for necesidad, to need. So you can click on the conjugation and you can see if the necesidad is you with the person tense with the yo form is necesito, and the do form is necesitas. And of course, in this sentence, we are using ustedes. Ustedes is necesidad. So you change it back to necesidad. Here, necesidad. Ustedes necesitan ayuda. Do you need help? Do y usted. When we use do or usted, you use the feminized subject pronoun do to address one friend, relative, child or pet, because it is informal, singular form of you. When you're talking to your friends, we're talking about a dog, you're talking to a child, you use the do form. So when you use the do form, let's say this example, tú eres mi mejor amigo, you are my best friend, and we use this word eres. This is the verb share. When you go with the pronoun do, you change the share to eres. This is the irregular verb. You can check it in the Spanish dictionary. Expect the verb to be share. And you can see the conjugation of this when you connect with do, you get do eres. You use that form to show respect to one older person or when speaking to a stranger or someone you don't know well, because the usted is the formal and the singular form of you. For example, es usted español? Are you Spanish? That means, are you Spanish person? And in here, es is the verb to be share as well. And when share is go with estar, we change it to es. You can also check in the Spanish dictionary when the share form go with estar, we change it to es. Es usted español? Are you Spanish? Vosotros, vosotras, y ustedes. You all and you all. Sometimes we use vosotros form and sometimes we use usted form. And the vosotros form is always used in Spain. Ustedes form in some South American country, they speak Spanish, they use the ustedes form for the you all. The vosotros, vosotras form is used primarily in Spain to address more than one friend, relative, child or pet. The informal form, the plural form of you. Vosotros me comprendéis. Do you understand me? And the comprender, to understand, when we are using with the vosotros, we change this to comprendéis. You can also check in the Spanish6.com. Comprender, to understand. And for the conjugation with the vosotros, you can see is comprendéis. So vosotros comprendéis. And in here, vosotros me comprendéis. Do you all understand me? Ustedes is the plural form subject pronoun. That's also express you. The ustedes is used throughout the Spanish speaking world is to show respect to more than one older person or when speaking to multiple strangers or people you don't know well. Ustedes son muy simpático. And this verb son is from the verb to be share. When this share is going with the ustedes, they change to son. Ustedes son muy simpáticos. You are very nice. Simpáticos mean very nice, very kind, and something like that. So you can check the verb share in the Spanish6.com and you can see the conjugation with the ustedes is son. Ustedes son. Ustedes son muy simpáticos. You are very nice. One more example. Él y ellas. He and she. Él refer to one male person. Ellas, she refer to one female person. Él toca la guitarra mientras ella baila. He plays the guitar. Guitarra mean guitar. Why? Mientras. Wow. At the same time. Si están. Ella baila. You can check the words doga and this was baila in the Spanish6.com as well. And doga. When the dogas come with the e or ella, it's changed to dogas. And when the baila to dance, come with the e or ella, usted is changed to baila. El toca la guitarra mientras ella baila. He plays the guitar while she's done. Ellos y ellas. Ellos, the masculine they, and the ella is the feminized they. Ellos, they refer to more than one male or to a combined group of males and females. No matter the numbers of each gender percent, ellas refer to a group of female only. For example, Juan y Jorge ellos escuchan, Juan y Jorge, Juan and Jorge, ellos, they. This is the masculine they, escuchan, is reasoning. This is from the word escuchar. You can check in the SpanishSpeak.com, escuchar. And the conjugation of ellos for escuchar is escuchan. So, Juan y Jorge escuchan, they listen. Luz y Susana, ella escuchan, is ellas, because this is the feminized, they escuchan, they listen. This means Luz y Susana listen. Juan y Luz, ellos escuchan. Juan y Luz, like this one is male and this one is female, but they join together, they use the masculine form of ellos, escuchan. Juan y Luz, escuchan, they listen. And finally, el niño, one child, y mil niña, and thousands of female child, ellos escuchan, they listen. This is only one male and thousands of females, but when they join together, they also use the masculine ellos for they. So it's the boy and thousands girls listen. They use the masculine form of they, ellos. Nosotros y nosotras, the we in masculine form and in feminized form. When you are talking about someone else and yourself as the same type, you must use the we. You can use nosotros or nosotras, forms of the word. Nosotros refer to more than one male in the group or to a combined group of males and females, no matter the numbers of each gender's person. Nosotras refers to a group of female only. Jorge y yo, we use nosotros to represent Jorge y yo. Jorge is George and I is we. Jugamos al tenis. Jugamos. Jugamos mean to play. This comes from the word jugar. J-U-G-A-R. It comes from the word jugar. You can also find these verbs, jugar, in the Spanish dictionary. And kick the conjugation. Jugar mean to play or to bet. You can see for the nosotros form, we use the jugamos. Nosotros jugamos al tenis. We play tennis. Ana y yo. Ana is female and yo use nosotras if you are a female. And if you are a male, you use the word nosotros rather than nosotras. Jugamos al tenis. Jugamos also come from the word jugar, al tenis. Anas and I, and here the I here is a female I, we play tennis. Omití por nombre de sujeto. We sometimes omit the subject pronoun in Spanish. Le presento a mi amiga María. Habla español. Let me introduce you to my friend. So introduce is to introduce. We use the presento. Me, I introduce you, a mi amiga Maria, to my friend Maria. Habla español, she speaks Spanish. So we omit the su here. Just habla español, not ella habla español. We know that this is su, Maria, speaks Spanish. So let me introduce you to my friend Maria. She speaks Spanish. Le presento a mi amiga, Maria. Habla español. And the habla is come from the word hablar, to speak or to tell. So ella using is habla. And presento is come from the word presentar, to introduce. And yo percento. So you can see it's le yo presento or yo le presento. Mean I introduce you to my friends Maria. In here, we also omit the yo, and in here, we omit the ellas. To avoid confusion, you regularly use the subject pronoun, usted, to differentiate between he, she, or you. Aba Espanol means, do you speak Spanish, or does he speak Spanish, or does she speak Spanish? So this is sometimes confusing. So sometimes you have to add the subject pronoun to make it more specific to you or she or mi novio habla español, habla bien. My boyfriend speaks Spanish and he speaks very well. So in here, you just omit the he because habla means he speaks or she speaks or you speak. But in the first sentence, you make it clear that mi novio, my boyfriend, so this should be here. Habla usted español? Do you speak Spanish? And if you change this usted into ella, habla ella español? Does she speak Spanish? So in here, the pronoun is very important if you don't want to make it confused. We continue the omit subject pronoun. Gandan bien, they sing very well, or you sing well. In here, this you is for the plural form of ustedes you. Mis primos están en el coro. Cantan bien. My cousins are in the core. They sing well. And in here, cantans mean mis primos, my cousins. So you can omit the subject pronoun they in here. Ustedes cantan bien también. You sing very well too. And here we don't omit the ustedes because I want to tell people that it is you, the plural form of you. If you omit the ustedes here, cantan bien también, this sentence may mean they, not you. Nosotros miramos la televisión cada día. We watch the television every day. In here, the miramos is the nosotros forms of mirar. So if you check the verb mirar, to see or to watch, to look at, and you can see here, the nosotros form is miramos. So when you talk about miramos la televisión, that means we watch the television. We don't need the nosotros here. Preparos la cena ahora. Shall I prepare the dinner now? We omit the yo in here because the preparos is the yo form of preparar. So the yo form is of preparar to prepare is preparos. So you can omit the yo here. Te veo más tarde. Veo mean I see. I see you later. Más tarde. More later. So in here, veo is the jaw forms of bear to see. You can also check and you can see the bear is the jaw form of bear to see or to watch. Te veo más tarde. See you later. Tiempo presente, the present tense. You also use the present tense with the verb hacer to make or to do, que, to show that an action start in the past and is continuing into the person. And this is called the present continuous tense. ¿Cuánto tiempo hace que usted estudia el español? How long have you been studying Spanish? You use the word hace que, and usted is the estudiar. So cuando, when the time. Hace que usted estudia español, you study Spanish from the past to here. So it's a continuing form. So it's you have been studied. ¿Cuánto tiempo hace que usted estudia el español? Hace 2 años. It has been 2 years hace dos años que estudió el español that I have studying Spanish. This estudio is studying. I have been studying Spanish for 2 years. Hace dos años que estudió español. Conjugación de verbos regulares. We conjugate the regular verbs. In English, I smile and he smiles too. So this smile is changing from S-M-I-L-E to S-M-I-L-E-S in the singular third person form. To smile is the infinitive form. And in Spanish, all verbs end in A-R, E-R or I-R in the infinitive form. Most words are regular, which means that all verbs with the same infinitive ending follow the same rule of conjugation. If you memorize the ending of one regular AR, ER, or IR infinitive form, you can conjugate all the other regular words within that family. Here's how it works. Take the infinitive and drop its ending. AR, ER, and IR, and then add the ending for the subject pronoun as indicated in the table and in this table. Let me take a verb, hablar, to speak or to talk. For example, this is the person 10 here. And we take out the AR and we add the O for the draw form. So the verb hablar, to speak, and change to I speak, we say it's hablo. Abbas. In the do form, you add AS. In the E, ella, or usted form, you add A. In the nosotros form, you add AMOS, amos. And in the vosotros form, you add an accent at the A, and IS, abais. And the ellos, ella, usted form, you add AN, aban. In here, abba, we will change to abo, abas, abba, abamos, abais, and abant. We continue some more example. This time we use the verb beber, to drink. Yo bebos, tú bebes, ella, usted bebes, nosotros bebemos, vosotros bebéis, and ellos, ella, usted, beben. This time we take out the verb ER ending and we add O, ES, E, EMOS, and EIS, EN at the end. So we have the following conjugation. And one more example, vivir, the ending in IR, to live. Yo vivos, tú vives, ella. Usted vives, nosotros vivimos, vosotros vivís, and ellos, ellas, ustedes viven. So all these three examples, we take out the AR, we take out the ER, and we take out the IR. For the AR form, we take out the AR, we add O, AS, A, AMOS, AIS, and AN. For the ER, we take out ER, we add O, ES, E, EMOS, EIS, and EN. For the IR, we take out the IR, and we add O, ES, E, IMOS. You have to remember this is not EMOS, it's IMOS and IS here for these two form, and EN for the last edge, beben. Conjugación de verbos regulares. We continue with the conjugation of the regular verb. Gana usted bastante dinero. Gana usted. That means you win or you gain. In here is the question sentence. So, do you gain bastante dinero, enough money? Bastante is enough or a lot of money. some money. So dinero is money. Gana usted bastante dinero. And the gana is come from the word to win or to earn. Gana. Gana usted bastante dinero. Do you earn enough money? No bebos café. Bebo is come from the word beber. No bebos mean I don't drink. Bebos mean I drink. No bebos mean I do not drink coffee, café. No bebos café. I don't drink coffee. Ellos deciden quedarse en casa. Deciden is to decide. Decidir, and we change to deciden, to decide. Quedarse. Quedarse mean to stay. Quedarse, to stay themselves. This is the reflexive verb, to stay themselves. They decide to stay themselves in the house. This means they decide to stay home. Ellos deciden quedarse en casa. And to here, I think we stop here for this section and we continue in the next section. Good luck. Bye-bye. 早晨，欢迎大家翻翻嚟我 Learn with Tom Lee 嘅西班牙文基础课程 Spanish Essential Espanol Essential。今堂我哋会讲西班牙文句子里面嘅现在式 The Person Tense Tiempo Presente。Tiempo 即系时间咁解。由而家开始啦，我将会咧系用英文同埋广东话咧系讲呢一个课程嘅。如果大家想睇英文版，the version 嘅話 ，the English version 啦 ，will be start at the beginning of the video， 係啊，喺呢個 video 嘅最開始就係英文版嘅。Tiempo de verbos 動詞嘅形態 ，regular verbs 規則動詞。These words are easy to get along with because they follow the regular conjugation rules for AR, ER and IR verbs。咁喺西班牙文裏邊嘅動詞啦。都是由 ER、IR 和 AR 結尾的。所謂的規則動詞，當我們做 conjugation 的時候，它就會跟一定的規則去改變。And the steam changing word， 有些動詞是不規則的時候，它就會改變它的 steam 的。Steam 就是那個動詞裡面的主要的字是會改變的。These words morph depending on how you use them in a sentence.You encounter three types of steam changing verbs, classified according to the steam change. E change to I, E change to IE, or O change to UE. 後面的例子大家就會慢慢明白。這些就是一些不規則動詞其中一個 steam changing verbs. Spelling change verbs 就是文字拼音的改變。Consonant spelling change occurs in some of the conjugate form of this verb. The change enables the words to comply with the pronunciation rules of the particular letters. The affected consonants are C, G, and Z. Consonant change 就是个主要的动词里面，当我们配合不同的代名词，我们就会改变那个字的写法 C 啦。有時候會轉做 Z，G 咧就會轉做 J 等等嘅，咁呢個就係個 spelling change 嘅不規則動詞。Irregular word， this word follows no rule and must be memorized。所謂嘅完全不規則動詞啦，就係唔會根據任何規則嘅。當我哋用唔同嘅代名詞啦，成個字啦都可能會改曬嘅。咁呢啲不規則嘅動詞，好似英文裏邊嘅不規則動詞啦。我哋就要死記嘅，例如英文裏面嘅 do、did 同埋 done， 係咪？你過去式、現在式，我哋都會改變啦，就唔會係淨係加 ed 嘅，因為呢啲咧係要死記嘅。我哋繼續 tiempos de verbos 動詞嘅形態 reflexive verb。Whenever the subject does something to itself, you use a reflexive verb to express the fact that the action is performed on reflected back onto the subject of the sentence. Reflexive verbs 在西班牙文裏面是很常用的。當我們有句句子，我們的動詞是形容翻個主要嘅主詞啦 ，reflect back to the subject 嘅話咧，我哋就會用 reflexive form 嘅。嘅動詞， 咁喺英文嚟講啦 ，reflective word 啦，例如 themselves、itself、yourself 呢啲就係個 reflective 嘅 pronoun 咯。咁但係好少會有 reflective word 嘅，但係西班牙文就會有 reflective word 嘅。El pronombre personal de sujeto 呢個係 subject pronoun， subject pronoun 啦，亦即係主詞啊，一個句子嘅主詞。譬如我食飯，我就係一個主詞；佢街就係、是、佢就係一個主詞嘅。A subject pronoun is a verb used in place of the subject noun。譬如如果你想講阿 John 做咗啲嘢，咁但你唔需要成日講阿 John 做咗啲嘢，阿 John 去行街，咁成日都用呢、這個，不如你用一個嘅代名詞。嗰、那個代名詞咧就係、是、佢去做咗啲嘢，就代表阿 John， 唔使再重複又重複嗰個句子，尤其是一篇文裏邊。This pronoun identify who or what is performing the action。是哪一個和什麼是做那個動作的 performing the action。 The Spanish use nine subject pronoun， 西班牙文就會用 yo 即是我 I do 即是你 usted 都是你的，但這兩個你是有什麼分別呢？這個你就是一個比較 informal 的，譬如你和 你的朋友去講嘢，你和你的下屬去講嘢，你就可以用 do。但是如果你跟一些上司或者你尊敬的人去講嘢的話，你就會用 usted 嘅。 L 佢啦，男性的佢 ；ella 就是女性的佢。Nosotros 我們，咁呢個我們是包括了男性和女性的 mixed gender， 即是我們裏面會有女性或者男性的。Nosotros 就是我們，不過我們全部都是女子的，譬如。我們是排球隊，全部都是女子的，我們會用 Nosotras。 Vosotras 和 Vosotras 都是一樣，這個 Vosotras 就是女性，這個 Vosotras 就是全部都是男性，或者是中間有男性有女性，是代表你們的，這個就是你們女性全部都是女性，這個是你們有男性有女性。但這兩個字在西班牙裏面才會用到的，在其他的譬如南美洲國家講西班牙文的國家就會用 ustedes 的。 ustedes 是代表了你們，無論是男性又好女性又好都會用 ustedes 的。 and ellos， ellos 即是他們，這個是男性的他們，全部都是男性， and ellas 是全部都是女性的他們，這個就是個代名詞。 el pronombre personal de sujeto主詞的代名詞。 First person 第一身，單數的話就是 yo 即是 I 我。 Nosotros 和 Nosotras 即是 we 我們，包括男性的我們 mixed gender 的我們和女性的我們。第二身單數就是 do 你，這個你是代表了同輩或者是朋友啦，講嘅你噶，咁而家大部分嘅講西班牙文嘅人啦，都會用呢個 do， rather 用 usted， 咁當然啦，我就比較中意用 usted 嘅，咁 usted 啦，亦都係代表你，不過呢個啦係一個 formal polite form 啊，你見到係 polite form， 呢個係 family form， 即係 polite form 啦，係較為有禮貌啦，你同平輩啦或者啱啱相識嘅人啦，當你講你嘅時候咧，你就會用 usted。Vosotros 和 Vosotras 亦即是你們，這個是男性的你們，這個是女性的你們。 Ustedes 就是男性和女性的你們，都是用 Ustedes。 你記住英文裡面你和你們都是用 use 的，所以有些講英文的人為了分別這兩個就會用 you all 的， you all 就是代表你們，讓大家可以分得清楚究竟我講你還是你們。First person 第三身單數 a 即是 he 他 ，ella 就是 she 亦即是他，不過是女性的。 ellos 是全男性的他們，或者有男有女的他們。 ellas 就是全女性的他們。現在我們看關於一些 el pronombre personal de sujeto subject pronoun 主詞代名詞。 John my voice，boy 就是 ear to live 或者 to go 的一個動詞，但這個是不規則動詞來的，所以當個 ear 是跟個 jaw 一起用的時候 佢就會 change 做 boy。咁我點樣 check 翻啦？你可以上翻一個叫 spanishstick.com 度啦，你就可以 check 翻個 ear 呢個動詞，然之後揀 conjugation。當你褪落去啦 ，ear 係 go with jaw 嘅時候啦，就會 change to boy， 係成個字都改變咗。呢、這個就係 irregular 不規則動詞嘅意思啦。所以係 jaw my boy 就唔係 jaw my ear 啊。咁 I am leaving jaw my boys。Eduardo y jaw。Eduardo y jaw 就係 Edward 同埋我啦。咁呢個好明顯係我們。Sarimo 就係 leaving。We are leaving 啦 ，Edwards and I are going out. Are leaving, going out. Salimos 其實係 Sali 嘅一個 form 嚟嘅。當佢 go with 我們嘅時候啦 ，Sali 就會 change 做 Salimos。你亦都可以 check 翻啦，喺個 Spanish stick 裏邊 Sali check 翻個 conjugation。你見到 Sali go with 呢個 nosotros 就會係 Salimos。所以當我哋講我們嘅時候啦，你就唔係講 Salia， 就係 Salimos。Eduardo y yo salimos。Edwards and I are going out。Busca usted， usted 係你啦。Algo 就係 something。Busca looking for， are you looking for something？ 你喺度揾緊啲乜嘢？咁呢個 busca 啦，當佢跟 usted 嘅時候咧，佢就會稱做 busca。其實真正的動詞啦，就係 buscar， car 嘅，呢個就係個 infinitive form of 呢個動詞。但係當佢跟個你 usted form 啦，佢就會轉成 buscar。我亦都可以喺個 spanishstick.com 嗰度啦，去揾翻 buscar， to look for， to find something。跟 usted 嘅時候啦，你會見到咧就係 buscar。Ustedes necesitan ayuda， 你們需唔需要幫忙 ？Ustedes 即係你們 ，necesitan 需要 ayuda 幫忙。咁但係呢個係問話式，你們需唔需要幫忙 ？Do you need help？ Ustedes 個 necesidad 就會轉成 necesitan， 真正嘅動詞應該係 necesidad。當我 conjugate with 呢個 ustedes 嘅時候咧，你會見到咧就會變成呢一個 necesitan。Usted necesitan ayuda. Do you need help? And this you is plural form. 呢個 you 咧係你們，唔係你啊。You use the feminized subject pronoun do. 你會用個 do form to address one friend, relative, child, or pet because it is an informal singular form of you. 幾時會用 do 呢？當你係同你嘅朋友啦、親戚啦、小朋友啦，或者係寵物去講嘢嘅時候啦，你用嗰個你啦就係 do form. Do eres mi mejor amigo. You are my best friend. 呢個就係 are 嘅意思。咁 do 啦。就用 eres 嘅，其實呢個真正嘅 verb to be 咧，應該係 share。但係當我哋跟 with do 嘅時候咧，我哋就轉去做 eres。你亦都可以去翻 spanishstick.com 度 check 翻呢個動詞 verb to be share。你會睇到當佢跟 do 嘅時候咧，就會係 eres 嘅 ，do eres。Do eres mi mejor amigo. You are my best friend. You use the usted.To show respect to an older person when you're speaking to a stranger or someone you don't know well because usted is informal, singular form of you. Es usted español. 这个 usted 你 español. 你是否一个西班牙人 Es usted español. 这个 es 也都是由个动词 verb to be share 那里转出来的。當個 share 係跟 usted 嘅時候咧，就會轉做 s 噶。我亦都可以睇翻頭先呢個係 share verb to be share。當佢跟個 usted 嘅時候咧，你會睇到佢就會轉做 s， 所以係 usted s 或者係 s usted。s usted español， 你是否一個西班牙人啊 ？Vosotros, vosotras y ustedes， 我哋會用 vosotros。 或者 Bosotras 代表你們，或者 Ustedes 代表你們。咁 Bosotras 同埋 Bosotras 啦，係喺西班牙裏面用較為多啲嘅，代表你們。The Bosotras form is used primarily in Spain to address more than one friend, relative, child or pet. The informal form, plural form of you 係你，不過係 plural form 你們。我哋會用 Bosotras。Bosotras me comprendéis. Comprendéis 即係 understand. Bosotras, you all understand me. Do you understand me? 呢個 you 係眾數嘅 you， 你們咁嘅意思啦。Comprendéis 啦，就係 comprender to understand。當我哋跟呢一個 Bosotras 嘅時候啦，我哋就會轉做 comprendéis。你可以走去 Spanish.com 嗰度 check 翻 comprender to understand 呢一個嘅動詞，當佢跟 with Bosotras 或者 Bosotras， 佢就係 comprendéis， 所以係 Bosotras comprendéis。Bosotras me comprendéis. Do you understand me? Ustedes is a plural subject pronoun that also expresses you. Ustedes 都係代表你們。Ustedes is used throughout the Spanish-speaking world to show respect to more than one older person or when speaking to multiple strangers or people you don't know well. 如果你同一啲朋友去傾偈嘅時候，你係尊重佢哋嘅時候，你就會講 Ustedes 代表你們啦。Ustedes son muy simpáticos. You are very nice. 咁呢個 you 啦係。不是 singular form， 是 plural form 的 you， 是代表 you all are very nice， 你们非常之好。这个 son 是由一个 verb to be share 那里过来的， ser share 那里过来。我们可以 check 翻 share， 当我们跟 ustedes 的时候，我们应该 conjugate 什么字眼的。当我们跟 ustedes， 就是 ustedes son， 我们就会用 son。Ustedes son muy simpáticos. You are very nice. 跟住我哋睇 e and ellas， 他呢个系男性嘅他 ，ellas 系女性嘅他。e he refer to one male person， and ella she refer to one female person。e tocas la guitarra mientras ellas baila。呢个 toca 系由 toca to play。或者 to touch 呢一個動詞轉過嚟嘅，呢個 baila 就係由 baila to dance 呢個動詞轉過嚟。咁當呢個 doga 跟呢一個 a 嘅時候啦，佢就轉做 doga； 當呢個 baila 跟呢個 aja， 佢就變做 baila。我哋亦都可以去 spanish.com 度去 check 翻 doga to play 或者 to touch， 你會睇到啦。當係跟 a 或者 aja 啦，佢就變成 doga， 好似呢個位咁樣。跟住 baila， 我哋可以 check 翻 baila to dance。當係跟 aja 或者 a 嘅時候啦，佢就變成 baila， she's done 或者 he's done。所以成句句子 a doga la guitarra mientras mientras 即係 meanwhile at the same time aja baila he play the guitars meanwhile。She's done。跟住我哋讲翻 ages 同埋 ages， 呢个系他们男性嘅他们 ，ages 系女性嘅他们。Ages they refer to more than one male or to a combined of group of male and females, no matter the numbers of each gender present。呢个 ages 啊系讲全男性嘅他们啦，或混杂在一个男性嘅他们啦，都会用 ages 嘅。Age refer to a group of female only. 呢個 ages 只係全女性嘅他們，我哋先至會用 ages 嘅。例如 Juan y Jorge 呢個係男性 Juan 咯 ，Jorge 亦都係男性咯，亦即係 George 咯。Ages escuchan 就係 listen， 咁我哋會用 ages， 即係 they listen。我哋可以 check 翻啦，喺 Spanish.com 裏邊 check 翻 escuchar。Escuchar 就是 to listen， 当我们用 ages 的话就是 escuchan， 所以我们会看到是 Juan y Jorge escuchan， 就是 ages escuchan。 Luis y Susana ellas escuchan. Luis y Susana 就係呢個女性咯。Luis 就亦都係女性啦，兩位女性啦，佢哋就係 ellas escuchan 就係 they listen ellas escuchan。Juan y Luz Juan 係男性 ，Luz 係女性，所以我哋有男有女嘅話咧，我哋仍然係用男性嘅 they ellos ellos escuchan。El niño the boy。Mil niña, thousands of girls, the boys and thousands of girls 都是會用 ellos 的，只要他有一個男性，就算是有一千個女性，我們都會用男性的 ellos, ellos, escucha。 我們解開了謎底之後，我們就會見到個英文的譯過來，英文裡面的 day 是沒有分男性女性的，都是用 day 的，但是西班牙文裡面的 day 是有分男性和女性。接著我們再看 nosotros y nosotras 同埋 nosotras， 咁 nosotras 係男性嘅我們 ，nosotras 係全女性嘅我們。When you are talking about someone else and yourself at the same time, you must use the nosotros or nosotras forms of the words. Nosotros refer to more than one male or to a combined group of male and female， 即係多過一個男性或者男性同女性嘅混合。No matter the numbers of each gender percent, nosotras refer to a group of female only. 而 nosotras 只是講我們，而我們呢度係全部都係女性先至用 nosotras 嘅。Jorge y George，Jorge 同埋我 and I，Jorge 即係 George 同埋 I 啦，係我們啦，我哋就會用 nosotras， 因為我咧係男性嘅話，或者係 George 係男性嘅話咧，我哋就會用。Nosotros 代表我們 ，Nosotros jugamos al tenis。咁呢度你會睇到 jugamos 嘅 ，jugamos 啦係 come from 一個動詞，嗰、那個動詞就係 jugar，jugar 即係 to pay 或者 to bet， 即係賭錢嘅 to bet 啦，或者玩一個遊戲啦，或者係彈吉他啦，去 to paint。咁我哋就用 nosotros 啦，就係用 jugamos。所以呢度會講 Jorge y yo jugamos al tenis， 或者 nosotros jugamos al tenis。George and I we play tennis。Ana y George nosotros jugamos al tenis。Ana and I we play tennis。咁 Ana 啦係女性啦 ，and I 一定要係女性啦。我哋全部係女性嘅話，我哋就會用 nosotros。如果 I 係男性而呢一度有埋 Anna 喺度都好啦，我哋就會用翻上高嗰個 Nosotros。Nosotros jugamos al tenis， 我們去玩網球。咁呢個就會用 Nosotros jugamos al tenis。Omit this pronombre de sujeto， 有時候我哋會 omit 咗嗰個 subject pronoun 嘅。咩情況會 omit 個 subject pronoun 啊？呢一度我哋睇睇 le presento。嗱 ，presento 咧就係、是、I introduce。咁所以我就omit 咗 jo 呢個字嘅，應該係 jo presento， 但我 omit 咗，所以就 le presento。I introduce you, a mi amiga Maria, to my friend Maria。Aba español， 即係 aba， 即係 to speak。呢一度嚟講咧，就係 she speak， 即係他講呢一個西班牙文嘅。咁所以我哋就 omit 咗個 she 呢一度喺度啦，即係 omit 咗個 ella 喺度啦。所以 le presento a mi amiga。Maria, habla español. Let's I introduce you to my friend Maria, and she speaks Spanish. To avoid confusion, you regularly use the subject pronoun usted to differentiate between he, she, and you. 如果大家睇翻 SpanishDict.com， 你揾到 habla 嘅話啦 ，habla 即係 to speak 啦，你會留意到啦，嗰個 subject pronoun 啦 ，habla 啦。可以代表 a aba、ella aba 或者 usted aba， 即係 she speak、he speak 或者係 you speak 嘅。所以為咗防止嗰個 confusion 混淆啦，如果你淨係問呢句 aba español 啦，你就會問 do you speak Spanish or does she speak Spanish or does he speak Spanish， 三個都有可能。如果你唔想混淆啦，你就用下低呢個 form aba usted español。Do you speak Spanish？ 即係 speak you Spanish 咁嘅意思啦，咁令到咧大家唔需要混淆。 但中間呢句就有少少唔同。 Mi novios habla español. My boyfriend speaks Spanish. Habla bien. He speaks very well. 呢個好明顯係 he speaks very well， 即係 habla bien. He speaks good. My boyfriend speaks Spanish. He speaks well. 我哋就唔需要用 habla español。 呢度我哋就可以 omit 咗嗰個 subject pronoun 啦。我哋繼續睇翻。 Omitivo nombre de sujeto， 我哋 omit 咗個 subject pronoun。 Cantan bien， can be they sing well or you sing well， 可以講係他們唱得好好咯，或者係你們唱得好好，因為我哋 omit 咗嗰個 subject pronoun， 所以呢句意思可能會係他們或者係你們嘅。但下一句咯 ，Miss Bean was as done an El Goro。 Cantan bien， my cousins are in the call。 Call 即係嗰啲合唱團咯 ，they sing well 呢個好明顯就係 they sing 啦，一定唔會係 you sing， 因為呢個簡單係代表咗 Miss Bemos my cousins。 Ustedes cantan bien también， you sing well too。 呢個 you 咧係代表你們啊，唔係你係你們，所以係 ustedes。 如果我哋 omit 咗呢個 ustedes 咯，喺呢一度啦。 呢個意思可能就會係簡單 bien tan bien， they sing well too 㗎啦，所以我哋就唔 omit 佢啦，保留翻喺度。Tiempo presente， present tense。 Nosotros miramos la televisión cada día，we watch television every day。 咁呢個 miramos 咧，其實咧就係 mirar 嘅 nosotros form 㗎，我哋可以 check 翻個 spanishdict.com 啦。 你會睇到 mirar to look at 啦 ，nosotros forms 就係 miramos， 所以當大家講 miramos 好明顯係講 nosotros miramos， 喺呢個情況之下，我哋可以 omit 咗個 nosotros， 個句子就簡單啲啦 ，miramos la televisión cada día， we watch television every day， preparamos la cena ahora， shall I prepare the dinner now？ 呢個 preparamos 就係 preparar 嘅 draw form。 我哋可以 check 翻咯，係 prepare 啦。To prepare prepare 個 jaws form 啦，就係 prepare， 所以當我哋講 prepare 啦 ，send 阿 Ola 就會係 shall I prepare the dinner now？ 因為 I prepare the dinner now， 不過呢個係問話式嘅。The bell must start this bell 即係 bell to see 嘅 jaw form， 即係 I see you must start this later。 I see you later. I will see you later. 呢個係 draw form 嘅 bear， 所以當我哋 check 翻個 Spanish dictionary 咯，我哋睇翻個 bear 就係 to see 或者 to watch， 喺 draw form 嚟講咧就係 bells。 當我哋講 the bell must start 咧就係 I see you， 就一定唔會係 he see you 啦，就 I see you later 或者 I will see you later。 Tiempo presente the present tense。 You also use the present tense with the word hacer。 有時我哋會用到啦 hacer 呢個字啦，即係 to make 或者 to do 啦，加個 呢個字啦，去表達 an action started in the past and is continues into the present， 即係現在進行式嘅。 Cuando tiempo hace que usted estudia el español？ Cuando tiempo, when the time, hace que, to do that, you study Spanish. And this means, how long have you been studying Spanish? 这个 hace que 就是现在进行式，就是英文的 studying 了。而 estudia 就是 estudiar 的 usted form。 Cuando tiempo hace que usted estudia el español, when you have been studying hace dos años, have been 2 years. Que estudio español, that I am studying Spanish. It means I have been studying Spanish for 2 years. Conjugation, the regular verbs. 喺英文裏面 smile 係 to smile， 即係微笑咯。 如果我講 I smile 就係我微笑啦，但係當我講 he smile 就係他微笑，我就會加 s， 即係第三聲單數加 s 啦。 而在西班牙文裏面亦都有呢個情況，呢、這個情況我哋就叫做 conjugation。In Spanish, all words end in AR, ER, and IR。 在西班牙文裏面所有的動詞都是由 AR, ER, IR 結尾的。Most words are regulars, which mean that all words with the same infinitive ending follow the same rule of conjugation. If you memorize the ending for one regular AR, ER, or IR infinitive, you can conjugate all the other regular words within that family.Is how it works. Take the infinitive and drop the ending. 我係攞個 infinitive 個 verb 咧，係拆咗個 AR、ER 同埋個 IR， 然之後加翻適當嘅 form 噶。我哋睇睇個 form 啦，用一個例子喺下邊嘅 table， 大家就會明白噶啦。我哋會用嘅例子就係 hablar to speak 或者 to talk。呢個 AR 呢個字咯，我哋會拎走嘅。當我哋去 join with 個 draw form、do form 或者其他 form， 我哋睇睇 person tense 現在式先。我哋拎走個 AR 前面呢個我哋叫做 steam， 我哋將個 steam 啦係加個 O 啦，就係個 draw form， 就係 draw apples、do apples、a ella、usted apples、nosotros apples 就加 amos 咯。Vosotros 就是 AIS,A 字上面有个 action。Ellos, ella 和 ustedes 就是阿板。你会留意到当我们读西班牙文的拼音尾耳那个音是重音来的。除非有个 accent 在上高，否则尾耳那个音通常都是重音。所以 jo 就不是 abo， 是 abo。Do, abas。E, ella, usted, abas。Nosotros abamos, vosotros abáis, 和 ellos, ella, ustedes, 就 aban。 跟着我们用另外一个例子，另外一个字就是 beber, to drink， 这个 ending with er， 我们就拎走个 er， in draw form， 我们加个 o， draw bebers， do form， 我们加个 es， do bebers， ella, e， 和 usted，我哋加個 e， bebe， nosotros bebemos， vosotros bebéis， ellos ella， usted bebe。 另外一個例子就係 vivir to live， 呢個係 ir ending， 我哋拎走個 ir 加個 o 就係 draw form， draw vivos， do vives， e ella， usted vives， nosotros vivimos， vosotros vivís， and ellos viven。 你会留意这三个的 form， AR 我们就拿走 AR， 分别是加 O、 AS、 A、 AMOS、 AIS、 A 字上高有 accent 和 AN， 而 ER 就拿走个 ER 加 O、 ES、 E、 EMOS、 EIS、 E 字上高有 accent 和 EN。IR 是最特別的， IR 我們拿走個 IR 加個 O ES E， 但這個不是 EMOS， 是 IMOS 和 IS， 就不是 EIS。 最後就是 EN， 我們就會有 Bebos 去到 Bebens 了。 Conjugación de Bebos Regulares， The Conjugation of the Regular Word， 我們繼續將一些規則動詞是做這個 conjugation 連接的。 Gana usted bastante dinero， Gana usted， Gana 是有個 verb Gana to win 或者 to earn 的， to earn you enough money， 但這個問話句，所以 do you earn enough money， Gana usted bastante dinero。 如果你 check 回個 dictionary， Gana 就是 to earn 或者 to win 的，而個 usted form 就是 ganas，所以整句句子呢就是 Gana usted bastante dinero， Do you earn enough of money？ No bebo café， I don't drink coffee。 Bebos 就是 come from the word beber to drink 去飲的，我們可以 check 回的話就是 beber， beber 就是 to drink， 而 draw form 就是 bebos， 也就是說 No bebos， I don't drink， I drink but no， 所以 no bebos, I don't drink 咖啡 coffee。 咁呢個咖啡呢同我哋廣東話啦係好相似，都係讀咖啡嘅。 no bebos, 咖啡 I don't drink coffee。 Ello deciden quedarse en casa。 Deciden 就係 to decide， 係 come from the word decidere to decide 嘅。咁 deciden 咧就係 they decide， 我哋拎走個 ir 啦，加個 en 就係 they decide。quedarse quedar 就係 to stay， to stay se依呢個 se 啦就係 reflexive word 嚟嘅。They decide to stay themselves in the house， that means they decide to stay home。咁所以呢一個我係稱為 reflexive 嘅 sentence。所以 reflexive 嘅 sentence 啦，英文裏邊係好少用嘅，啊有不過好少用。咁我哋廣東話更加唔會用啦，我哋唔會話佢哋決定將佢哋自己留喺屋企啊，好似好沉係咪？我哋只係講佢哋將自己留喺屋企就夠啦。好啦，到咗呢一度咧就差唔多個 video 都好長啦，咁我哋就留翻下一次再繼續講呢個 video 嘅嘢啦。咁希望大家中意收聽我呢一個嘅 video。Thank you， 拜拜。Okay, if you think this video is good and can help you, please subscribe and give like. So you press the button at the lower right corner to subscribe. And remember, when I have a new video, you better click the bell sharp and see the new video. Thank you. Muchas gracias. Again, thank you very much for listening to my tutorial videos. And if you need a private tutor for you to get a better mark or better score in your DSE examination in Hong Kong,the SAT examination, or just you want to improve your mathematics and English for your college and university study, please contact me at qingtong929@yahoo.com.hk. My telephone number is +1 852 659 2 8609. 好多謝大家收聽我呢個 video。 如果你希望你個 mathematics 同埋你個英文係更加好嘅話，你想要一個 private tutor 啦，你可以隨時 contact 我嘅，令到你個 DSE exam 啦，或者你想考 SAT 啦，你亦都可以 contact 我，因為我都有一啲私人嘅補習喺呢一兩方面嘅。多謝大家 ，thank you， 拜拜 ，muchas gracias。